So one had a question for layout of a scene. Usually what I'll do is set it up kind of like this, to where I know like what's the next segment that I'm gonna use as far as the scene. And I'll usually set it like this. So if there's a scene about arriving somewhere, I will use this kind of template to remind me of what is going to be the next installment. So if I understand this is the scene where there'll be our arrival, it'll just remind me of what the next thing is. If there's anything tragic, I'll usually put that frame kind of all together. But what it allows me to do is, once I see the image, it'll remind me of exactly what is supposed to be going on in that segment of the scene. And then I just rotate them based on, you know, time and where I want to put everything. But I always use Inkscape for that, and I just basically have everything all in Inkscape. And even if you wanted to frame them where, you know, you wanted them side by side to kind of give you a kind of what's next sort of the scenario, I'll use this so I know what's, you know, what I'm concentrating on next, especially if there's something where I guess I could use this. For instance, there will be a tragedy, right? So I'll have it everything lined up the way I like, but it'll kind of pace me into understanding, okay, well, this is the tragic. And if you're working with someone that's doing the music or doing anything as far as keeping in sequence, I always come back here and it'll remind me, okay, this is happening now, this is going to be the next thing. And if you're breaking them up with action and then suspense and then tragedy, it'll give you like a block chain of, you know, should I have this scene here or should I move that maybe on a little bit further down the timeline. And you could break it up into segments to where, okay, well, is this too much emotion going on for this particular scene? And then you may lighten it up with, okay, in this scene, we're going to be lightening it up a little bit. But it gives me kind of like a sort, like a dragnet of different elements that I need to be reminded of. Because I'll start asking myself a lot of questions. Okay, you know, is this from here? And then I can put the frame of where I want it. But I usually set it up like this, and then I'll have times that I'll put under each individual action. So I'll know exactly, all right, this will be 5 minutes. You know, the next one will be, you know, 7 minutes. And then it'll allow you to either, if you're doing cuts for scenes or trying to really keep a good, what I call sequence, suspense, you know, tragedy, action, all of those things, it'll give you an idea of the breakdown. So if I know that I have a tragic event and that scene is going to be a 3 minute scene, you can pace yourself and understand, okay, well, this is too close. And then you could start figuring out, do you need to move things around? There's different methods that you can use to do that. And it'll give you a breakdown of what's going to be more important to you, and what do you want to say as far as the story element is concerned. But I try to kind of give other people the option, and I'll ask friends or somebody that I'm, what do you think about this or that, or is that too boring, is that too much excitement after a tragedy, all of those breakdowns. For me, it'll kind of have good pacing, and then you always be objective, where we'll have someone else come in, ask questions about, okay, what do you think about this, and you'll match it up that way with a lot of different methods of how you want to lay it out. But this, for me, it's helpful. A lot of people will do box by box, and they'll do just a sketch. But if you have the one main thing that you know what's going on in that scene, visually, for me, it's a lot better not just to sketch anything out, but just have exactly what's going on in each segment of the scenes. But yeah, that's about it on that. I don't know if other questions. I think that was it for a lot of the questions. The other thing is, whenever I do get into a situation where I do have everything framed out the way I want it, if I'm, I wouldn't say exhausted, but if I've been working on a particular scene for a while, and you want to break from that sort of whatever, if you're doing the artwork or whatever you're doing, right? You want to break from that kind of scene. It does help, if you're working on a tragedy scene in one instance, maybe you'll work on the action scene, right? And then you're not like bored. And I get that way sometimes, where I'm working on something and then it's not like a sloppy output, but it's take your time in what you're doing and understanding how important that is, because other people will have opinions. I find myself a lot of times whenever I am doing the art, you can get into a thing where you're what I call slow rushing, where you're so involved in that particular scene, maybe you start skipping steps, things like that. But breaking up the monotony of just keep doing the same thing, after a while, usually I'll find myself not being excited about that particular scene or that drawing. So I'll break it up and then I'll just go to something totally 100% different, where it'll kind of get my mind in a whole nother frame of thinking or reference. And for me, it does help a lot, and not to be bored with it. And sometimes you do have the times where you're just zoning in, and then your focus is totally on that, and it's fine if it's fun or engaging. Just make sure that you don't get bored whenever you are doing it, I guess would be the best thing to suggest. Alright. Thank you very much for watching the videos. For the people who are getting the timeline of me getting everything together, I will be working on a trailer a little bit later, and I will probably reveal that on the other videos. But I do appreciate people watching the videos and then giving me questions and things like that. I do appreciate it. All right, thank you very much for watching.